Last lecture, I got to know that many students are facing problems in understanding of diamond structure. So keeping that in mind, in this lecture I am going to explain about diamond structure, and in the last of this lecture I am going to explain little bit about wurtzite structure, because these two structures are very important in understanding of semiconductors. Especially compound semiconductors are formed in either diamond or wurtzite structures. So first I am trying to explain diamond structure. And I am sure all of you know the definition of diamond structure. That is, the diamond structure, diamond lattice, consists of two interpenetrating FCC lattices, where one lattice is displaced along the body diagonal of the other with 1/4 of the length of the body diagonal. So what is diamond structure? In diamond structure, one FCC lattice is displaced to another by 1/4 of the length of the body diagonal. And here I am taking two FCC lattices. One is drawn in red color and other one is drawn in blue color. And please note these atoms. This atom is at the face of the front surface of this cube. And this is at the face of the back surface of this cube, and similarly this one. So by displacing this blue lattice, I am going to draw a structure that is similar to diamond structure. Here I am displacing this blue lattice 1/4 of this length, that is the length of the body diagonal. And please note that if this point is D and this point is D, then this DBD is equal to under root 3A, where A is the this length of the cube. BD is equal to under root 3A, and this length is 1/4 of this BD. That is, if this point is C, then what is BC? BC is 1/4 of this body diagonal. So here I displaced this blue lattice 1/4 of this body diagonal. This is not exactly, but I am just trying to show the geometrical representation of this structure. So here we can see, when I am displacing this blue lattice 1/4 of this body diagonal, then we can see this atom, this one, this atom, this atom, and this atom, this one, this one, this one, and this one. These four atoms are in the red lattice. And please note that this atom that is on the front surface of this blue lattice is outside this red lattice. It looks that it is in the lattice, but it is on the front surface of this blue lattice and it is outside of the red lattice. So in this way we can form a structure that is similar to diamond structure. In diamond, these all atoms are belong to carbon, but here for better understanding I am drawing these two structure in different colors. So here we have to know the bonding of this atom, this atom, this atom, and this atom, because these four atoms are in the red lattice. So in next diagram I am going to connect these four atoms to their neighboring atoms. So first let me start from this corner atom. We know that this atom is at the corner of this blue lattice and this atom is near to this corner. And please look carefully, this corner is made by this upper surface, this side surface, and this back surface of the red lattice. So we have to connect this atom to this, to this corner atom, and then to this atom that is at the surface, at the middle of this upper surface, and other one is to this one and to this one, because these three faces are making this corner, this back surface, upper surface, and this side surface. Similarly for this atom, this atom is near to this corner. So first we have to attach this atom to this corner atom. Now if we look carefully, this corner is made by this upper surface, this surface that is the front surface of this red lattice, and this surface. So we have to connect this to this surface, to this atom, and the third one is the front surface, this one. Now I am changing the color of this. Now we have to connect these two atoms. So this atom is near to this corner, and this corner is made by this surface, that is the lower surface, this front surface, and this side surface. So we can connect this atom to this, to this, and to this front. Now we have to connect this atom to this atom. Sorry, this atom to this atom, to this atom, and to the atom that is at the back surface of this red lattice. Since this atom is near to this corner, and this corner is made by this surface, this lower surface, and back surface, so we have to connect this atom to these three surfaces, to this one, lower one, and back one. See lattice. So in this way, all these blue atoms are connected by four red atoms, and this is the diamond structure. Main thing is here, we have to imagine nearest corner of this atom, and one more thing is that here two atoms are present along this diagonal and other two atoms are of this inside are placed along this diagonal. That is, two atoms from the blue lattice are present in this direction and other two are present in this direction. So this is the important point in this diamond structure. And in next image, here you can see clearly, that is, these four atoms, that is one, marked by two, three and four in gray or black color, are from other lattice. So here clearly we can see that this atom is belong to this corner, front surface, this side surface and lower surface. Similarly, this atom is belong to this corner, this surface, that is the all the surfaces, that is, those are making this corner. Similarly, this atom is connected to this corner atom, to this surface and back surface, because this corner is made by this back surface, this side surface and this upper surface. Similarly, this atom is connected to this corner atom, and this corner atom is made by this upper surface, this side surface and this front surface. So this is connected to this surface, to this surface and this surface. In this way, we can make a diamond structure. And here all the atoms are connected in a tetrahedron. And similarly, actually, this atom, this lattice is similar to zinc blend. Because there is no difference between diamond structure and zinc blend structure, and only difference is that in diamond structure all the atoms are belong to carbon element, but in zinc blend structure these four atoms are belong to other element. So this is about diamond structure. And I hope now you can imagine this diamond structure. Now I am going to explain some little bit about wood thread structure. Wood thread structure. Similar to diamond structure, a wood thread structure is made by hexagonal close packing structure. First, let us see how we can make a hexagonal close packing structure. For this, we have to put first layer of these six atoms, that is at the corners of this hexagon, and in close packing we have to put another atom at the center of this hexagon. Now we have to put other layer of three atoms. Please note that we can only put three atoms, one is here and one is here. We can't put six atoms here, that is one here, one here, one here, one here. It's not possible. We in second layer we can only put three atoms. So Now we have put these three atoms, and on a third layer again we can put these six atoms. In this image I am showing these three atoms below these six atoms. That is, this is A layer, this is B layer, and this in purple color in C, A, B, C. So in this way we can make a structure like this. That is A, sorry, this is also A. If we put like the A, B, C, then this structure looks like a FCC, but in hexagonal this is A, B, again A. And please note that there is no gap between these two atoms. Both of these are connected. So this is hexagonal close packing. From using this hexagonal close packing, we can make a Wurzite structure. For a Wurzite structure, we take one hexagon from one element, that is, that's A, and other hexagon with other elements. If we take an example of, let's say, zinc sulfide, then one hexagon is belong to this zinc and other belongs to this sulfur atom. So finally we can make a Wurzite structure like this. Here one hexagon that is made by these blue atoms, and other hexagon is started from here, that is made by these yellow atoms. So in this way, by displacing this yellow hexagon lattice, we can make this Wurzite structure. And this Wurzite structure is also important in understanding of compound semiconductors, because at high temperature most of the compound structures are formed in Wurzite structure. I hope this lecture will be helpful for you. In next lecture we will study about the crystal structure of compound semiconductor that belong to 2 and 6 groups.